Fine.
Able-bodied adventurers.
Oi there, Outlander. Name's Vilgund. Did you come to the city looking for work? Oh, good shards. Enough to buy garb more becoming of your...
Okay, stop there, if you want me to hear you out.
I only meant a well-molded woman such as you. I heard an interesting rumor about a Banuk camp. Tame machines, the rumor said. So I hired men to investigate. Just investigate, that's all. Those Banuk are canny, too canny. I paid up front. Well, half up front. I've had no word back.
So now you're hiring someone to find the last men you hired.
They're a sunk cost. This rumor's worth more to me.
Are you some kind of merchant? You don't seem to have any wares.
More of an explorer.
But you send other people to do your exploring.
All right, more of an opportunist. Girl, Nora girl, Huntress, we live in a world of opportunities, risky opportunities. But why should risk stand in the way of a lucrative prospect for the likes of me? All right. I'm more of a gambler.
What can you tell me about the Banuk?
The Banuk women. Snow witches all. Cold eyes, cold... They choose to live up there in Banur, in the ice. Trying to have a conversation, it's like chipping them out of the stuff. They prefer machines for company. That's why I'm putting my shards on this rumor.
Then they might not want outsiders to know about this place.
Their mystic act. No care for possessions, for luxuries. Pile of slag. Those people bargain harder than the winter frost.
So is there any more to the rumor about this camp?
The last bunch just wanted to know about the reward. Hey, you're a smart one. This camp isn't even big enough for a name up where the snow won't thaw. They say the Banuk there live alongside machines. Peaceful as you like. Keep them, use them, sing to them. If it's true, if we learn how they do it, think how valuable that would be to all the tribes.
When you say valuable, you mean they'd pay you for it.
Girl, I'm not made of straw.
If I did look into your rumor...
You won't need to climb up the shoulders of the world for it. It's on the edge of Banuk land, beneath the anvil of the moon. And you look like you know your way around the savage east. The east. If it's true they walk among machines without fear in this camp, well... You can't miss that, can you? Payment on return.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, it's vessel collectibles.
Whoa. What's going on here? I don't remember this. You got a quest for me too?
You're Nora. I'm the mournful Naman. My apologies that we meet like this.
Like this?
In grief. You hold yours close, like a talisman. Wait, forgive me. You didn't come for reparations? Someone you lost to the Sun Ring?
No. I know about the Red Raids, but the Carja owe me nothing.
I see. Well. I could use the help of a strong-willed outlander. Then I would owe you very much indeed. These people seek to honor their loved, their lost, with their own voices, not mouthing Carja rituals to Carja stone. But there are obstacles. While Meridian holds its breath for any disturbance, these robes only tie my hands.
If I could help, what must be done?
The first pilgrim is an Asaran who seeks to visit the Shrine of Kings on the road to the city. He waits there now, forbidden to enter by an old sun priest who suffer no heathen. This Utaro lost her companion on the edge of the jewel, at a pool where snap moths gather. The shrine was built there to ward off the machines, and its effectiveness leaves much to be desired. And the Banuk would paint a mark on the sun's climb, a call to the machine spirits, I understand. They need no beckoning. Glinthawks perch there, drawn to the spire's shining.
So clear the machines out of two shrines and move a priest out of the other.
All I can ask for is your charity and that their stories are heard.
I'll do what I can to help those in mourning.
To honor their memories is to honor us all.
Well, it sounds like that quest might take you to the spire, which does interest me.
Move along.
Hmm, yes. I remember you. Did you find the vessels I seek? Yes, yes. Trade quickly. I have work to do.
Yes.
What sort of ritual were these vessels made for?
I'm convinced they were used in conjunction with each other in sets. Some people believe they were used for tea ceremonies. Others think they held sacred essences and oils for worship. But I believe they were used for the solemn custom of shaving one's beard. One for water, one for lotion, and so on. Each fluid in its special vessel, majestically applied to the face at each stage of the rite. It must have been breathtaking. But which vessel was used for which? I have to know. I have to continue my research.
Are you sure people didn't just drink out of them?
Drink? Out of such finely crafted earthenware? Don't be ridiculous!
So you're interested in the old ones?
More than interested. I study every ancient artifact I can get my hands on. But years of study have made me too comfortable at my desk. I can't even bear the sun, if the truth be known. I don't know how I'll manage to take a partner. My family presses me for an heir.
Don't look at me.
Oh, no, I'm not looking. In fact, my father already has someone he wants me to wed. She doesn't interest me. I wish I had a brother to carry this burden. I would rather be left to my precious little vessels.
Okay.
I will leave you to the hunt. Be sure to delve into the ruins. Yes. You look capable. You might do.
Let's take a look at this. It's got boxes inside of boxes.
Arrested two for disorderly conduct last night.
This must be the Shrine of Kings that Naman told me about.
Osram slaves built that place. We deserve to have a look. It's a public monument, not his private shrine.
You won't get in there. That dried up old prune in a robe sees to that.
I can be persuasive. But what does an Osirom want with a Carja shrine anyway?
It reminds me of someone. Gone 2 years now. But what does a girl like you know of loss?
Try me.
I had a lover. Worked on monuments to their bastard king. Then he gave them a show in their sun ring for good measure. The Carja gave me back his broken bones, but what use are they? They won't build again. They won't make me smile.
And seeing a statue of the Mad Sun King will?
I need to see his work again. The marks his hands carved. The set of the metals they hammered. That's the soul of him. But that shriveled up old priest won't let me near it.
I'll see what I can do.
Turn away, child. The abiding Jahaman wishes to be alone in his retreat.
If you want to be alone, go someplace else. Others want to pray here.
Defile it, you mean? Yet another debasement of what was once pure. Truly, our tribe has lost the light. Our king is false, our temple is corrupt, and our soldiers weak. The sun hastens across the sky for shame.
I thought of Vod taking the throne was the sun's will.
The boy dishonored his father. Dishonored us all. To kill a sun king. What shadow, what twilight time he brought upon us.
And how many more would the mad sun king have killed if Avad hadn't stopped him?
The sun called for blood. There was no choice but to obey.
I'm done arguing with you. Stay or go, but I won't allow you to keep others away.
I am here by the will of the sun.
You don't believe in the throne, the priesthood, the army, or the city, so I guess you have no authority here.
I have the authority of the sun!
Then call it for help. No one else will listen.
There'll be a reckoning.
You'll back away from it.
Kept the wheel turning all day, and by the forge I believe I've earned a drink or two.
Oh wait, I guess he's gonna thank me now.
You're dressing him too fancy. But he's made a place in the Sunder for the Oscar.
He gave them the best work he'd ever do. And look at it now.
They defaced it because they hated what it stood for.
They defaced a thing slaves like him lived and died for. Slaves they've already forgotten. Short-sighted bastards, the lot. If they thought their son set off this bridge, they'd jump after it. I thank you for honoring my wish.
I hope you can find peace.
I wouldn't know what to do with it, any more than the Carja do.
Must be the sun's climb, where the Banuk wants to paint his mark. feeling it.
Cool place over here.
Now, what were you doing out here?
I found a metal flower. I don't know what these are supposed to be. Okay.
You are a better hunter than I. I'll paint the mark while the spirits of the Glinthawks linger.
There'll be more where they came from.
Yes. There will always be more machines. Their spirits find new bodies, but we only last as long as memory. That's why I must leave the story. A monument to our vanished shamans, to the wisdom the Carja bled from us. The machine oil in the paint will preserve it, preserve their memory against all that was cut away. You have my thanks, Hunter.
One way to do these quests would be to learn how to override these machines, but since we're not there yet, we're just gonna kill them. You die now. Oh, hello. It's a really good thing that I have the charger. Or that guy would have killed
me
or gone out.
Where we never left.
Oh! Whoa, whoa, whoa! You're my friend. I don't wanna kill you. It's gone hostile. Why are you hostile?
Thank you.
When we fled from our cages during the liberation, I tore through this clearing, thinking my friend was behind me. I kept running, but here she remains. Thank you for making it safe for me to return.
I don't want to rush you, but it won't stay safe for long.
I understand. I've done this before in waking dreams. In the pool, I'll find the bracelet of seeds she dropped when she fell. The seeds will be split, escaped, grown wild. She's passing from my memory into the jungles. I'll tell her it was I who died here and became a stranger in our own land, and she who still lives in every time of planting, of rains, harvests, and... Oh.
What is it?
There. Her bracelet. And... I thought she was behind me. But there's only my reflection.
Do you need to be alone?
For the first time, I am.
So you've come back to the temple.
I was invited back. The priests wanted to hear what I had to say about reconciliation with the other tribes. They're listening. At least they've begun to listen. There's a distance between ears and deeds.
Because of what we did?
What you did?
It was for the mourners. I think it helped them.
You set them on the path. You can't know what their journeys hold.
Such is the priest's lot. Perhaps a red robe would suit you.
Not me. Besides, your temple doesn't even take women.
We would be richer if we did. Go in light, my friend, and let the sun cast your way.
Thank you, Naman. Where I'm going, I could probably use all the light I can get. Listen. The machines are docile. It's like they've already been overridden.
My song will echo for 100 more.
Machine spirits are angered in all places but this one grove.
Greetings, Nora. I am Tikuk.
Shaman, I've never seen anything like this.
The blue light is strong here. My people traveled far from the heights of Banuk to experience it for themselves.
The blue light?
The light of the machine spirits. It is all around us. It settles upon us. This is how it used to be, before they grew angry.
I know about the derangement, but I didn't think the machines were ever this calm. What is it about this place?
We don't really know. We sing, and we listen to the machine songs.
The machines sing to you?
To each other. You are a hunter. You must have heard their communions and hymns, their calls and cries. We're not meant to understand, but we shamans try to interpret. What is the song that angered them so, that turned them upon us? What song soothes them? Does it thrum in the air here, just outside of hearing? How can we heal the machine world?
What's with the big guy?
I was drawn to this place in a storm. At first, I thought the keening was the wind, snapping off the mountain's frozen face. But no, it was the Thunderjaw's song. I found it crouched on its haunches, its metal unmoving, and I took shelter beneath it. When the storm cleared, its singing done, perhaps the spirit left its great shell, or perhaps it slumbers and remains, So we have not stripped and gleaned this one. We treat it with the care it is owed.
Teacook, have any other outlanders come through here recently?
Some Asaram, yes. They were convinced the machines were malfunctioning. As if machines were mere devices in need of repair. Well, that is how the Asaram see the world, is it not? They ate with us. Then, when they were satisfied there was nothing they could explain, they left with the Northern Light.
Do you mind if I look around more, Teacook?
Speak, trade, listen. You are welcome. No harm will come to you here.
So it's not the Banuk that are doing this. There's something about this place. They can't see it, but maybe my focus can.
Machines grant you favor.
I could check my focus, see what it sees. There, a signal. And the source is at the top of the mountain. I'd better look into it. This is how the Banuk must have gotten up and down the mountain.
Never mind that. Nora girl, you have to stop the others. Up ahead, we snuck up. Uncovered some kind of ancient device, plain as an anvil. That's what affects the machines.
The other bungheads voted to take it to Pitchcliff for auction. But it's taken a beating already. Like it dropped from the sky.
Look, we tried to stop them digging out. Without that thing up here, those Banuk will be massacred.
I'll stop them. You two get out of here. It sounds like you've already done enough damage.
Well, that's a fair appraisal.
Let the rope slip off, you bunch of chuffskulls.
What have you done?
Who are you? You're not one of those Banuk.
Too late. Let me look at it.
Hold on, hold on. This was our delve. We did the work. You want to put your axe in? What's this thing worth to you?
I don't know about this. This was your idea. You started it, you can finish.
All right. Could be this thing's just scrap, but even scrap has a price. So I'll ask again, what's it worth to you?
It's worth more to me than you are. You still want to negotiate?
Forget it. All he's ever given me is black toes.
They've made a mess of this. Catastrophic malfunction. This is from long ago. And it's been sending a signal all this time, fading out. I have to get back to the camp before the machines tear it apart.
Come on, are you kidding me? No, 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 no. Hello.
Yes.
Oh, stop it.
Roar and rend at me. I don't fear it. Hear my song, machine. A sharp song.
Did you know this change would come upon us?
Not Exactly. Although I know there is a lot changing in our world. This time it was outsiders. Those Oseram thought.
The Oseram do not think. They will never understand the balance between us. Between man and machine. Now the blue light has gone. And we are left with many songs. But more for mourning than gratitude.
So what now? Will you go back to your homeland?
When we teach the young to walk on shifting ice, we say, the secret is taking one step, then the next. Perhaps one day, we will understand the machine's mysteries.
I hope so. Good luck, Tikuk.
Able-bodied adventurers, preferably with no Outlander. Are you looking for... Wait, I know your face. You came back. How did we fare?
Expensively.
That's what I was afraid of.
The tame machines. It's hard to explain, but there was a kind of signal that calmed them. Your men got greedy, so it's gone now.
Gambling's a shoddy job, girl. I should have been a weapons dealer. That's steady work. Here, take it. The half I'd owed those hammer-handed chunks.
Half? I finished the job. And what was it you said? Enough to buy a more becoming garb?
What do you want? Carja silks? Ah. Hoisted on my own purse strings.
Looks like quite an enduring victory we put our foot in today.
Contact in 30 seconds.
Hey, think that's enough time for Sobek to finish Zero Dawn?
If this is really it, I gotta say, it's been an honor to serve beside these tanks.
Here it comes.
Grease for contact!
Silence, you getting this?
What is it?
All these soldiers. They died here.
People die all the time. I'll keep going and find something interesting.
Operation Enduring Victory.
Operation Enduring Victory. What did that mean? Whatever it was, doesn't seem to have turned out very well. Must have been where the soldiers slept. Like the lodge in Mother's Heart, I guess.
Log. Third Battle of California Marine. The swarm came in from the Pacific, and I don't know if it was the local Minutemen or the crazy 15th, but they'd set the garbage patch alight. Man, the sea was on fire. That stuff was pretty. The first wave of bots came in covered in burning sludge. It bought us an hour or two of slaughtering them on the beaches before the swarm recalculated. We pulled them inland, back through the Kalmar sprawl. Dropped buildings on them, EMP'd the grid. Standard operating procedure. The last time I was in California, I was 5, 6. The light was like that vintage social net filter that was everywhere in the 40s. Log. First battle of the Eastern Seaboard Wall. Had a long run up to it. This was before Kalmar. And projections were a lot worse for the east. For 3 weeks, we kept getting scrambled out to some coastal burg to train Minutemen. It was always raining on account of Europe already being torched. Block after block of prefab barracks. They were still printing barracks right up until the hour the main force hit. The Minutemen?
What was this
place? We ran combat drills with them in the streets where they'd lived, trying to pretend they might live to die somewhere else if they paid attention. Nothing worse than the ones who actually bought into it. Hopeful, pestering us with questions about Zero Dawn, like, we know something they don't. I swear, the more we do this, the more like the bots we are. Except they learn from every fight. And us? I'm not so sure.
Recalls, I've been instructed to remind you of Article 115 of base policy regarding unauthorized use of processor cycles. Specifically, 115C. Any holographic simulation not directly related to operational training or efficiency. Consider yourself reminded, and enjoy your gaming.
Thanks for the mails, you. Time goes fast on active duty. 4 months with the wreck and recalls, I don't know, 20 drops. In and out of the West Coast, fighting with these civilian enlistees, scrappy guys and gals. Their training is basically, here's a DEW, when you see a bot, hit it. But somehow it's all coming together. Between us and the 6th MRB, we took down a horse at Lithium Beach. Pulled out before its buddies arrived, but to see a big one go down. I hope you made the news, honey. Showed everyone we're gonna have a shot at turning this around. We just need to give Project Zero Dawn the time it needs, then everything will be the way it used to be.
Don't think so.
I know it's been days, honey. I'm so sorry. Deployments are getting real long and tougher every time. The swarm's getting better at predicting us.
The furnishings
less of us now.
Metal.
And we have to put in 10 times the work for everyone gone.
It was
like a family business
world.
On hard times, only this isn't my family. It's not with you. I still try to see you. The life we had in the eyes of the people out there. I remember when they were glad to see us. When they still had hope. It all seems to be slipping away. I don't even recognize the places we're defending. The only thing I know I'm still fighting for is you. For Zero Dawn to turn this around? Whatever the hell that is.
They were fighting the robots, and they were...
These wires must run to the power source.
They were executing Project Zero Dawn.
I guess that means no power.
We're waiting for it to happen. But clearly it was not, not gonna be hopeful, whatever it caused. Let's hopefully they'll tell us soon. There we go.
Tunnel's been raised. No glasses. No eclipse. Must be another way in. It's them, all right. They're not looking for answers, just for weapons.
Keep moving and keep your eyes open! The girl!
Thank you.
anything better to do. Think that. During eclipses, the shadow cast on the moon is curved. So our world is a globe. And it looks like this, from a distance.
We'll discuss this another time. Back to the matter at hand.
The Faro robots were spreading across the world, eating everything up. Somehow, Elizabeth stopped them before it was too late. But how?
Oh no.
The eclipse. Tampering with a metal devil. They don't think they can wake it, do they?
Watch out!
Kill them for once.
Another Kopish, and this one can move. Was gonna happen. Thank you.
is there a cover? There's no cover anywhere. This thing could have helped me. Wait, I couldn't have. It fell through the floor.
Thank you, Dr. Sobek. You can take a seat. What? You're going to thank her after what she just said? Dr. Sobek has made the situation very clear, General, and given us an option. We should all be thanking her. No, it's just... I mean, my God!
Maybe take this discussion offline.
There's not going to be any discussion. You saw the numbers. Now, Pharaoh, he'll foot the bill, but his money can't buy the time necessary to complete Zero Dawn. That can only be paid for in blood.
Oh, come on. If we upgrade our fleet, crack the code somehow...
Were you not listening? Robots can't do the fighting for you this time. When it comes to hacking, this rogue swarm is an apex predator. Anything automated you throw at it, they will hijack and take over.
But this, we'd be throwing civilians into a meat grinder.
Commanders, the enemy we're facing self-replicates faster than we can kill it. And it eats biomass as fuel. Zero Dawn is all we've got.
So we put a railgun in the hand of every civilian strong enough to carry one, show them where the trigger is, and point them to the front? How the hell do we sell that?
By giving them something to fight for. Zero Dawn. The top secret super weapons program that will save us. So long as humanity holds off the swarm long enough for Dr. Sobek and her team to finish it. The file I'm sending contains the war plan for Operation Enduring Victory.
War plan? This is a war crime.
It may be ugly, but it's something. Consider the alternative. Dr. Sobek. I've secured use of a decommissioned orbital launch base outside Bryce, Utah as the Zero Dawn staging area. Plenty of space there. When can you get started?
I've already mailed you a list of Alpha and Beta candidates. Most are foreign nationals or subjects of corporate holdings, so extracting them...
Leave that to me. You'll get your dream team. Can't I?
Then I'll be off.
Trace. What is that? What did these people do? What did Elizabeth do?
Dr. Sobek, as projected, the Wichita salient has collapsed. 5 Horus-class Titans have broken through. We predict contact in 34 hours.
Everything is in position, General. It took a few shortcuts to pull everything together, but Zero Dawn is functionally complete. Good to go.
That enduring victory served its purpose after all.
Yes, if we'd had even one day less.
I've sent you an encoded file, Doctor. Please do me the favor of archiving it.
I'll see what I can do. What is it?
A brief statement. An allocution of crimes, I guess you'd call it.
To what are you admitting guilt?
Over the past 16 months, Doctor, I have presided over the greatest wholesale slaughter of military personnel and civilians in the history of history. Genghis Khan, Hitler, Stalin, Sorabella, add them all together. They don't even come close.
You didn't do the killing, General.
No, not directly. But I didn't wind up the highest-ranked military commander in the United States by resisting the automation of the armed forces. Even before the swarm, Doctor, I was helping death along. So, instead of letting what I've done sink into the murk, forgotten, I sent a file with all the details. Let posterity judge my actions with clear vision.
I'll do as you ask, General. But you should consider that, were it not for your actions, our actions, there wouldn't be any posterity to judge us.
Perhaps. Dr. Sobek.
At ease, General. And goodbye.
Hell of a thing.
Glad to be rid of that place. Now I just need to find the orbital launch base they talked about.
I've checked my data and located the base. That's the good news.
And the bad?
It's directly underneath the Citadel. The palace at Sunfall.
The capital of the Shadow Carja. Not exactly convenient.
The palace is crawling with Eclipse agents. Many in positions of authority, all of them wearing focuses. The moment they see you, Hades will too. He'll issue another kill order, and this time, the entire Shadow Carja military will be after you.
So, disable their focuses. You've done it before.
It's not that simple. Too many focuses in one place. Each of them communicating with each other and back to Hades, a whole network of them.
Network? What's that?
Imagine a vast, invisible web stretched across the land from end to end, connecting focuses together, allowing them to communicate over vast distances instantaneously.
All right. So, is there some way to cut the web down?
Crash the network. Audacious. Yes. There is a way. A weak point in the network.
Point the way.
I'll send the location data to your focus. Head there, and I'll be in touch when you're close with more directions.
What was Zero Dawn? What sort of super weapon did Elizabeth make? She stopped the machines, not before the world she knew, her civilization, ended. Let's hope it won't come to that again. Now, how am I gonna get down from here? Oh, this should be quite the ride.
I don't see the way down. Well, that didn't kill me that time.
Do that again if it weren't so much work to get back up there.